Hi, this video is to show you how to fill out both the old CEA form and the new ALCA form. I'm going to show you how to do the ALCA form first because most of you will be familiar with the old form, and then at the end of the video I will show you how to do this form that you see in front of you if you need that. Okay, so the ALCA form is again what we were sent via Jared Tollett, or we might have got it from Jessica. So you're going to go to ssc.alca.is and you're going to type in your SSC email. Make sure that you're using all lowercase letters. When I tried signing in the first time, it automatically capitalized the first letter and that wouldn't accept it. And then the password is going to be all lowercase letters, fall 2021. Going to hit sign in. We're going to go to the dashboard, which will have a sentence that says this site is only for SSC. Please exit if you're not from SSC. We're just going to ignore that. We're going to go up here to where it says assessments. I have already filled out my reports, or at least part of them. So you will not see anything here unless you've already created reports. So what you want to do is you're going to click assessments with the plus. Your name should automatically appear. You're going to click Fall 2021. You're going to go down to the class that you're assessing. You're going to then say what section numbers that you taught. So, and then you're also going to say face-to-face, online, or Zoom. So it's really important. You're going to report your Zoom, your online, and your face-to-face courses in separate forms. So I had an online comp 2. I had a face-to-face comp 2. I'm only going to be doing the face-to-face here, and that's section 4. If you taught multiple sections of that class, then you would click the section numbers there. Under number of students to be assessed, I'm going to type in how many students completed both the pre and the post tests that I gave them for our assessment. Now, your class may only have a pre-test and a post-test. So again, whoever completed both the pre and the post, that's who you use. If you have two assessment tests, so you have a pre-test, post-test, and then in English, we also do a pre-post write. You would only assess the students for all four of those tests that completed all four of them, all right? So now all I have to do is just say pre-test, again, for writing, we only, it's a pass-fail test. So in writing, we put in how many students passed the pre-test the first time, and then how many passed it in the post-test, right? If for writing, we're also then going to put the pre-write and the post-write here on the second line. So again, pre-test is line 1, pre-write is line 2. And here for English people, remember, we don't give the number of students who passed the test or the writing. We actually give the average of all the students who completed the pre and post-write and the pre and post-test. We're just going to eliminate anybody that didn't do all four, right? We're going to add up the scores of all of those test results, and then we're going to divide by the number of students that took that to get the class average. And so we're going to put that the average there, there, and then the average of the post test there. We do that because if we simply said pass who passed it, you might have quite a few students who come in with C level pretest but ended up with B or A level post tests. We won't see that improvement if all we do is count how many students passed, because they would have passed both, right? So that's why we do the average there. When I get done, I'm going to hit save. I shouldn't have any reason to put notes because, again, there shouldn't be any reason to put a note. If you have multiple rows and you don't want to actually type in each of them, you can use the copy and paste function. So let me show you how to do that. I can click copy and paste. It's going to open up my pane. Then I'm going to go to my actual spreadsheet and I'm going to copy and paste the columns. Now, in Jared's video, he actually said you need to copy 3 columns. I'm not sure why, but here, if you're taking it from this form, you just need to copy the pre and the post test numbers. And then I'm going to come over here and I'm going to paste, and it's going to say save, and look, it replaced those with those numbers, right? So, you know, don't do that if you've already put the numbers in there. And that'll, again, you can do as many as 11. I don't think any of our classes have a breakdown like this. So again, you probably won't need it. So that's how you do it. You just then create another report for your other classes. And again, remember, you're reporting online, face-to-face, and Zoom classes separately, even though they may be the same class. You're going to separate them by delivery method. All right, I hope that helps you. Again, if you have questions, you can email me. If you can't get a hold of me, then you should email Jessica, but I should be the first person you email because I'm the one who is spearheading this and talking to Jared. So I should have the answer, or I can get it for you if I don't know it. All right, so after this, now we're going to talk about how do you actually fill in the old form. At this point, they are recommending that we fill out the form, but they're not requiring it. I'm going to tell you that you need to keep it at least this semester, because if there are any problems with the ALCA forms, like if we didn't put in the numbers the way they really want them, at the January in-service, we're going to have to actually redo the form. So if you have this form filled out, all you have to do is just transfer the numbers. You don't have to go back and, you know, check your scores or anything like that. So I would recommend doing it just so that you have it. I'm not sure if we'll be able to access the ALCA forms after the semester is over. I think we should be, at least for a little bit, but if you want to have these also in your own records, I would also recommend filling out the form. So here's the form, and again, you should be getting an email that has this attached, so you can open it up. You're going to put your name here. You're going to put the semester, so again, that's going to be fall 2021. You're going to say how many numbers of courses. So on this form, we put all of our courses on it. We don't just do one for one class and another for the other, right? So here I've got 6 classes. So I'm going to put that there, and then I'm going to put the course numbers here. I'm going to put the section number here. And then if I teach other sections, I'm going to fill this bottom part with those other sections. There's only room for 3 sections. If you taught more than 3 sections of the same course, again, you might just record that over here since we're not actually having to turn this in. Then you're going to put the title of the course. You're going to indicate face-to-face or online. If it's a Zoom class, we count that as on face-to-face. The ALCA report, though, actually identifies Zoom as separate. Then we're going to, again, put how many students are we assessing. And then you're just going to put in the number, the pre-post number. So this is an old form. And we would only put like how many students passed it and how many students failed on this one. So, but this one again is where we would do the average. So again, you know what your course needs. Again, if you're using the average of results or if you're actually using just pass fail, you know, populate that the way you need to. Then you're going to save it and again, have that on hand in case we need it. So again, good luck. Email me if you have questions. Happy holidays. Bye-bye.